Our biggest interest as we start implementing this MOU will be in working with us to profile small and medium enterprises that have potential to supply to free zones that are existing.
According to the executive director of the Uganda Free Zones Authority, Heze Kimomi Alinda, the only way government can ensure that Ugandans generate enough income is by creating effective demand for goods produced by the population. It is this urge that has prompted the Uganda Free Zones Authority to sign a memorandum of understanding with the Small Scale Industries Association. This implies that the small scale traders or companies can now supply goods to the free zones for export, a move which is deemed to be a step in the right direction for not only the country, but also the small scale traders.
When you hear a company producing a particular commodity which is really big on the export market, there are so many small companies bringing certain parts that eventually form the product that goes out. And the good news about free zones and the emergence of the Africa Continental Free Trade area is that, well, we are still developing the rules of origin, but they are not yet concretized.
To fully achieve this, Uganda Free Zones Authority is to embark on profiling small and medium enterprises that have the potential to supply goods. Key among the aspects to be considered is the quality and quantity of products.
We shall share a list of the various free zones that especially in the agro-processing area, to see how we can profile these SMEs, how much can they produce, how much can they supply, so that we go into formal contracts where we see that there's a clear linkage, much as some of the SMEs at the moment may not be exporting. But when you actually sell a product from Uganda into this free zone, which is outside the customs territory, you've actually exported.
Veronica Namwanje, the executive director of the Uganda Small Scale Industries Association, said the memorandum of understanding they have appended on signatures today has been long overdue, optimistic that it will create more jobs and other opportunities.
If free zone can offer this particular service to our members, this is what we've been timely waiting for. How do we get them to kind of have better services, lowered standardization fees to have their products be wanted within the other countries where they could be actually be exported? It would even increase a lot of opportunities and jobs.
Specifically, we're excited about the public free zone in Entebbe that is coming up. We had a discussion recently with our members, and they were all looking forward to tapping into the opportunities that come into it. There's a lot of work that UFSA reduces, and we appreciate that fact, and we appreciate the fact that UFSA is getting on board.
Uganda Free Zones Authority also intends to ensure export readiness for the industries. They will now put more effort on empowering the manufacturers to make them more competitive. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.